Welcome to PCR TV at EuroPCR 2019. It's my pleasure to be with Phil McCarthy from London and Michael Lee from Hong Kong. First of all, what's the news actually with the valvular disease? There is a very huge volume of TAVI actually. And what is the new challenges? What we learned during this course?
Well, there certainly is an explosion in the demand for TAVI all over the world, and we're trying to come to terms with this, and this course has helped significantly. We've learned about simplifying the technique so that we can do a minimalist procedure. We can minimize the risk to the patient by minimizing the number of arterial lines we use, from pacing from the Safari wire, from direct stenting, and from sizing the valve accurately, particularly in bicuspid valves, and there's some very interesting data on all of these topics. We've also learned how to minimize the risk, because of course we're moving into an intermediate and low risk population, and we have to minimize the risk. And we've learned a lot this Congress on prevention of stroke, trying to identify patients who are at risk from stroke and in whom to use the distal protection devices, which is a real key feature of making the procedure safe.
Yes, and for the low risk, there is something news or what happens exactly?
Yes, we see actually more and more evidence on the use of TAVI for low risk patients. But we have to bear in mind that we are talking about low risk patients, but not very young patients. I would be very skeptical about the TAVI procedure in very young patients because the durability of the valve has not been shown yet. So it's not really for the very young patients. And then in the long run, coronary access is another problem. If we implant a TAVI device, the patient, young patients have to go under a coronary intervention sometime in their life. So if we do a TAVI for very young patients, this might be a problem in the future. And Phil mentioned about the lower risk, the safety of the procedure. Yes, it is actually getting more and more safe. Minimalist approach is good for low-risk patients, but still we want to give them more protection, like cerebral protection, renal protection, try to minimize the risk in these low-risk patients as much as we can.
So good news. Yes. And what about the valvular disease, like mitral valvular disease?
Well, mitral, the whole area of percutaneous treatment for mitral is extremely exciting. The edge-to-edge repair with MitraClip has been hugely energized by the COAPT trial and the MitraFR trial, and there's been lots of analyses as to why those trials differed. We've seen here that the population for MitraClip therapy is also increasing. We know that it's a good therapy, but the devices are becoming more refined. We have more choice in the size of the clips that we use, and we can do more patients as a result. So again, a huge population, expanding, lots of challenges, but this Congress has shown us a number of ways in which to improve their care as well.
And I think we don't forget to the tricuspid valve. What about?
That's right. Tricuspid valve is always the forgotten valve. So in this course, we see more and more interventions to help this sort of patients, at least with the clip device. A lot of new devices are available. I have the feeling that with more and more device becomes available, this technology actually will help those patients with our tricuspid regurgitation as well in the very near future.
Thank you, Michael. So what about the live case formats?
You know as well as I do that EuroPCR always evolves. Yeah. It examines the way that it delivers education. Every year it's different, but this year there have been changes to the live case, which I think have been excellent. The live case has been transformed so that the panel is more relaxed, that the chairman walk around a little bit more mobile to make it more interactive. And there's also a technical expert with a screen that the technical expert can draw details on. And it's been really transformative the way that the technical expert can bring specifics about the live case to the audience. All the while this is going on, the React PCR questions are coming in from the audience. So if they see something that the technical expert does, they can ask and they can drill down on these topics. So for me, it's a great evolution, and it's much more educational, it's much more focused, and it's much more directed towards the audience and involving the audience.
Exactly. And what do you think about the other session, other learning session?
Yes, I think the PCR courses have been very good in that they actually put a lot of emphasis on the teachings and learning session. for this year, we see more and more of these sessions on every aspect. People just react by learning through the discussions. And like transeptal puncture, there's actually a lot of interaction between the speakers and the attendees, and they really can learn a lot. And also, we like the case discussion sessions a lot. We all think that it's much more effective to learn through cases.
Yes, I think it's a very, very great opportunity in during the EuroPCR to have a companion, to be companion, and to learn a lot from each other. I think it's why it is not a meeting, but a course. So I think it's a great world, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Martine.